Hey guys, welcome back to the food forest. It's the beginning of the blossom, and this is the amazing apricot, tomcod it's called, and this year I think it's so beautiful. And I think especially the apricot blossom is amazing with these red sort of covers. I don't know what you call these in English, but right now we have perfect weather for pollination, and it's always like a nail-biting moment every year, because sometimes it's snowing, sometimes it's frost, sometimes it's a lot of hard winds in April. So the weather is very changeable, at least here, and I think it is in many other places. And these trees are maybe not perfect for this zone, but if we are lucky and we get pollination, good pollination, we can get a lot of apricots, and they will ripen and they are completely delicious. But this tree, along with some of the almond trees, are some of the first to come out. And today is, as you can see, a really, really beautiful day, and it has been for the past couple of days. But now the weather forecast is, there's talk about hail and strong winds and all of that. So I'm keeping my fingers crossed that it's not going to be too bad, because otherwise we won't get any bitter almonds. This is a bitter almond, and there's a sweet almond over here on the other side. This, along with the peach trees, are the first blossoms to come out. And I wanted to talk a little bit about pollination, because I can see the pollinators that we have right now. It's about 4 o'clock in the evening, in the afternoon. It's mainly honeybees. They're not from our garden, but some visitors, and they're very welcome. But I see that earlier in the mornings, often it's a lot of the wild bees, the solitary bees that are also in the garden. And I think it's so important to have a lot of different pollinators. Diversity in the pollinator population is also really important, because it looks like the wild bees are less picky with the weather. They will fly in worse weather than the honeybees will. And even the bumblebees, that are a lot of different bumblebees in the garden, and they are very important pollinators. And they are like tanks when they fly around, and they will fly in quite harsh weather and pollinate if they can. So that's super important, and I'm hoping you can see the beauty and keep your fingers crossed with us. We don't get a hailstorm smashing up the flowers, and that the bees will have had enough time to pollinate. This is the sweet, just a normal almond. Looks really beautiful also right now. I think I love the trees when some of the flowers have opened and some are yet to open. I think that's the most beautiful point. So I'm constantly underneath these trees and looking to see what kind of pollinators we have. And I'm really pleased to say that we have loads of different ones. And yesterday I was so happy. I found a new kind of bee that I haven't seen before. It's a new bee for this area. Well, it's from 1984, but it's still quite relatively new. And it's called rødpelset jordbi, ANDRENA FULVA. I'll put the name in the link in the description below, and it's so beautiful. So Google it if you want, if you're a bit nerdy like me. So yes, pollination is very important, and it's a nail-biting week, this. So we hope for kind weather. Thanks for watching, and see you later.